coaches. I spent a year doing research just based on Canada alone with some real life stats. And then when it's time to start building the platform, I reached out to Upwork. Upwork, if you know, it's a website that you use to connect with a different kind of like consultant to help you with your business. And I found someone there who, his name is Carlos. And he basically rebuilt my platform from scratch. I had a local person build the beta, and I launched and tested that, but I needed a custom site to do everything that I wanted to do with that. So Carlos is based in Monterey, which has been mentioned. It's almost 6 million people, so it's roughly the size of Toronto, which is kind of perfect. So all of the testing that we've done in Toronto, we can kind of do the same testing in Monterey and generate interesting results and kind of set aside like, okay, which one has the most ROI for instance. But I'm getting ahead of myself. Coming back, so you know, he approached me at one point and he said, would you be interested in moving your business to Mexico as well and opening up shop here? So we had some conversations. We generally worked over Skype, so you know, we have a lot of long conversations by Skype. So I asked him a little bit about the market there. I asked him a little bit about like why does he bring this up? And he referenced the same thing. Like, there's 90 million cell phones, and there's a huge outdoorship in Mexico right now. And he said that's just taken off in like the last 3 or 4 years. So, you know, the Ubers of the world are coming to Mexico. You know, they have a kind of a shopping app where you can send out a courier and just bring you, you know, if you want a jug of orange juice, bring it right to your front door. It's, you know, kind of similar to like Uber Eats, but we'll get you back. So these kinds of apps have taken off in a huge way in Mexico. He saw a real opportunity, especially because they do have an establishment of some sports bar out there. So talking about that briefly, you know, they have a few areas that are really big. So boxing is one of these there. Taekwondo is a really big market there for them. But then also, if you extend that into sports such as soccer, they have a lot of sports teams there who play soccer on the side. So like, when you look at numbers globally, that the sports and fitness market is roughly growing by 6.5-6.6% per year. In Mexico, depending on what stats you look at, it's either kind of 6.7, 6.8, or 20%. So the 20% growth includes, you know, these local sports teams, so people are joining up for soccer more and more, it seems. Really fascinating considering that, you know, this is helping people book sports. The other area is just the market itself. So there is, you know, as with many, many Western countries, there is an obesity issue in Mexico. They are number 5 for diabetes in the world, but number 1 for child obesity. And so to me, that speaks to a problem that needs to be solved. Of course, this is about what entrepreneurs do, right? You go to a platform that tries to solve a problem. So coming to Mexico seemed like a pretty good idea because what it looks like is we have a population who needs fitness. We are seeing the opening of many other small boutique gyms there as well. So as you know, in Canada, like, we used to have Good Life Fitness, but we still do. They used to rule the scene, but the trend has been changing in the last several years, and now you're seeing boutique gyms opening up at a crazy rate. Like, how many have you seen, like, F45s or Anytime Fitness, but all these small boutique franchise studio gyms? That caters to very, very targeted markets. They're having a problem filling their classes. Now, the same thing started to happen in Mexico. There are maybe a couple years lagging behind, say, Toronto, for instance, but they are coming across the same issues. So they have a couple of big sports chains, like Sports City, I forgot the name of the other one right now, Sports World. So they do have some large chains as well, but they are seeing these small, independent shops open up, mom-and-pop shops. So what we're going to be doing is connecting them and personal trainers to the people who are looking for the classes. The export show last year, the Startup Canada Export Accelerator, and I had a brief chat with her, so I was on their mailing list, and I had, you know, followed them on LinkedIn. So it was really just a moment of kismet when I saw there's an accelerator that they were launching to help people get into Mexico, so I applied. Now, we already planned to open a shop there, but getting into a lot of startups program really helped me to understand what I was doing. So before going to Mexico, what it looked like was a series of meetings about accounting, tax, employee relations, marketing, sales, so like the whole know, the whole industry kind of just touching on PPE every bit. But it's important because there are, you know, the tax laws are different. The billing APAR, so accounts payable receivable, has a much different structure than we have here in Canada, that there is no way I can do myself. So I am definitely going to go for that. But I wouldn't have known that otherwise. I would have jumped in and then realized, oh no, I'm out of my debt. So, you know, but also meeting other consultants that can help us grow our business and help us understand the landscape there. Now, my developer Carlos is very, very connected with the local modular scene, but we were looking here in Mexico City. So it gave us a chance to meet with accelerators there, with angel corporations there, some other companies who are really big in the marketplace. And it was really a very good experience applying the knowledge they learned in those 3 days in Toronto. It really helped, you know, whether it's just the culture itself, whether it's having a really good foundation and how business is done there, so that when we went into meetings, I wasn't surprised or shocked or caught off guard. So the transition was really, really smooth. The food is amazing, isn't here. Mexico City is far more beautiful than anyone would ever describe. Monterey is hotter than tell you, but the mountains are just incredible. So, I mean, I honestly can't wait to open up shop there. It looks like it's going to be a few months because we have all our ducks in a row now. It's just going to be the most incredible experience going down there, coming back, and feeling like this is a very feasible test and protection of waters. I love that we have I love that the time zone is only 1 hour behind. You know, doing someone from, say, for India, that was a much different, you know, challenge, right? But here, it's only an hour behind. It's only a 4-hour, 5-hour flight. It makes a much more feasible extension to the business than it would be in